越发展，这个年轻人越不愿意当结婚。
是，大家都想自由点。
对，都想。主要现在跟过去不一样，现在妇女都独立了，不是？
那是。
都有自己的收入，他所以说长不长的他就。
In China, people are expected to get married or have kids at a certain age, for example, before 30. We wanted to understand the pressure that millennials are facing.
So we're here at Zhongshan Park, which is one of the biggest marriage markets in Beijing.
On every Thursday and Sunday, parents would come here hoping to find a perfect match for their kids.They lay out sheets of paper on the sidewalk with information about their child and the requirements for interested partners. The bio includes age, appearance, house ownership, income, education, and hukou, the registered permanent residence.
从这个收入上来说，这个事情，其实挺有趣的。北京的情况，如果你写是比如说8000块钱以下，你可能就没有人去，搭理你了。我后来查了一下北京的。社平工资在2017年是8000多块钱，已经超过这个数了。女士来讲呢，当然超过8000当然好的，但是超过15000之后，就不是一个加分项，而是一个减分项了。很多男士觉得对方的这个收入太高，可能对自己压力会比较大。很多高知高收入的女性，其实在相亲市场上其实不是那么吃香。中国人传统的这个观念里，还是男方应该提供这个房产，所以在相亲里面呢，大多数的女方要求男方。要有这个房产。通过统计局的人口这个数据调研发现呢，就是这个城市的户口越难去获得，对户口要求会越高。北京2017年户籍人口是负增长，所以说想拿到这个北京户口是难度是非常高的。然后有户口的男士或者女士在相亲市场上还是会比较受到青睐。
The first marriage markets emerged in 2004 in Beijing's Longtan Park.Parents visiting the park found they share the same anxiety that their kids may be alone forever, and they began to gather regularly. It soon became a trend in China's major cities.
But the parents were not very comfortable speaking to us.
别看了，这个父母啊，心都伤透了，你们在一块更伤心了啊。
I wanted to experience marriage market myself, so I printed out my own bio with information like age, education, hukou, and income. And this is what happened.
做什么工作呢？
新闻记者。
多高啊你啊？
我真不高，我可能穿上鞋有1.06米吧。
对。
I feel quite depressive, to be honest. You're kind of just like an item on the shelf.
父母肯定是爱自己孩子的，不然可能也不这么冷的天在这边说这样的相亲角里面，孩子可能不理解父母这个行为，然后觉得自己被变成了一个物化的商品在这里被售卖。
We could gauge that there was a disconnect in what the parents wanted and what the children were looking for in a partner.
我告诉你好早。
And I, like other youngsters, would rather wait to find someone who is the right mix of the things we value.
What do you think about marriage markets? Have you ever felt pressure to find someone and get married?
Share your thoughts with us. Next Saturday, we will meet Ma Renyi, who set up WeChat dating groups for those with higher qualifications.